श्रीवास्तव टीचिंग यू मैथ्स ऑफ क्लास 9th NCERT चैप्टर 11 कंस्ट्रक्शन चैप्टर। इन दिस चैप्टर यू विल गेट द बेसिक कंस्ट्रक्शंस। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शंस। क्लास 7th वी हैव ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एंगल्स एंड द ट्रायंगल्स। अदर ऑल द थिंग एंगल्स एंड द ट्रायंगल्स यू हैव ऑलरेडी कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन द क्लास 9th। ट्रायंगल SAS ट्रायंगल कंस्ट्रक्शन RHS कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड अदर ऑल यू हैव फिनिश्ड इन क्लास 7th। हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल गो नो द बेसिक थिंग्स। बेसिक थिंग्स मीन्स हाउ विल यू कंस्ट्रक्शन द डिफरेंट मेजर ऑफ द एंगल बाई द साइड बाई द स्केल कंपास एंड द पेंसिल्स। सो वेरी सिंपल वे यू विल कंस्ट्रक्ट ए पेयर ऑफ ट्रायंगल आर ये सिंपल ट्रायंगल 60 degree। हाउ विल यू ड्रॉ द 60 degree? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल ड्रॉ ए लाइन, देन ऑन द लाइन यू विल पुट द कंपास, टेक एनी रेडियस, मार्क द आर्क लाइक दिस यू आर सीइंग। हियर यू विल मार्क द आर्क्स एंड फ्रॉम सेम रेडियस यू विल पुट हियर एंड मार्क द आर्क। द फर्स्ट आर्क इज द 60 degree एंड विल ज्वाइन एंड प्रोड्यूस इट इज अ 60 degree। 90 degree सेम प्रोसेस। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल ड्रॉ ए लाइन। आफ्टर ड्राइंग ए लाइन वी विल टेक अ कंपास एंड पुट द कंपास हियर, टेक एनी रेडियस एंड मार्क द आर्क। एंड आफ्टर मार्किंग द आर्क फर्स्ट आर्क सेम रेडियस वी विल फर्स्ट आर्क, देन अगेन द सेम रेडियस यू विल सेकेंड इट इज द फर्स्ट वन, देन यू विल गेट द सेकेंड वन, देन यू विल गेट द थर्ड वन, देन फ्रॉम हियर यू विल मार्क द वन आर्क हियर टॉप एंड वन अनदर आर्क फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट हियर यू विल गेट इट इज़ ए 90 degree। 120 degree इज द सेम प्रोसेस। फर्स्ट यू विल ड्रॉ ए लाइन, टेक ए पॉइंट एंड टेक एनी रेडियस यू मार्क एन आर्क लाइक दिस एंड फ्रॉम हियर यू विल कट द वन पार्ट 60 degree एंड सेकेंड इज द 120 degree एंड यू ड्रॉ द थर्ड वन देन इट विल बी द 180 degree। सो यू विल कीप इन योर माइंड हाउ विल यू ड्रॉ इट एंड इन द बुक इट इज़ गिवेन फर्स्ट वन। वट इज़ द गिवेन इन द बुक? फर्स्ट टू कंस्ट्रक्ट ए बाइसेक्टर ऑफ द गिवेन एंगल। फर्स्ट कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द बुक इज बाइसेक्टर ऑफ द गिवेन एंगल। हाउ विल यू डू? वी विल डू द बाइसेक्टर ऑफ द गिवेन एंगल बाई दिस गिवेन ट्रायंगल एंगल ए बी सी। एंगल ए बी सी इज गिवेन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल ड्रॉ ए लाइन एंड देन ड्रॉ ए एंगल ए बी एनी एंगल। दिस एंगल यू वॉन्ट टू बाइसेक्ट। फर्स्ट स्टेप्स ऑफ यू राइट गिवेन टू कॉन्स्ट्रक्ट एंगल बाइसेक्टर ऑफ दिस एंड स्टेप्स ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन। ड्रॉ फर्स्ट स्टेप ड्रॉ एंगल ए बी सी आई हैव सीन B as a center. First one, B as a center, mark an arc of any radius which intersect the AB and BC at D and E. So put the compass at D and make a radius, any radius you mark the arc like this. You are getting it is intersecting these two arms D and E. D and E as a center. Now you put the compass at D and E, anyone. And more than half of it are full. You mark an arc this side and the D also you mark an arc inside of this. Both are intersecting at a point which is your bisector. Intersecting at P, BP join and produce you will get BP is the required angle bisector in which angle ABP is equal to angle CBP. Next one is given. Second type of construction in the book is given. Second type of construction you see. What is the second? Construct a perpendicular bisector of a given line segment. To construct a perpendicular bisector of a given line segment. For this what will you do? In this case, first of all, we will take given. What is given? A line of 8 cm. I am taking AB. To construct perpendicular bisector, it is given in class 6 also. Steps are first you draw a line. First of all, we will draw a line of 8 cm drawn, you are seeing. Then second step, A and B as a center, more than half of it, mark two arcs. which intersect each other at P and Q. E and B as a center. More than half you will take. More than half. A as a center, both the side you mark an R. B as a center, both the side you mark an R. Both are intersecting at P and Q. Join PQ by scale you put on the cross and this you join. When you join it, where it intersects, that point is M. M is a point which is bisect the line AB, and also the PQ is perpendicular to this line. So you are getting perpendicular AM is equal to MB and it is a 90 degree. Third type of construction is given. Third type of construction in the book is given to construct an angle of 60 degree at initial point of a given ray. So that already I have told you, initial point of the given ray. So first of all you take a ray, OA is a ray whose initial point is O. OA is a ray whose initial point, OI. OI is a ray whose initial point is O. You want to draw a 60 degree angle, very simple. What will you do? At O draw 60 degree. Steps of construction, draw ray OA first. Second, O as a center, mark an arc which is intersect OI at A. O as a center, put O any radius. Any radius, I have taken this radius. And you will mark an arc like this, which intersect OA and A. Now, A as a center, same radius, because 60 degree previous page I have told you, same radius, you mark another arc which intersect the previous arc at B. And join OB and produce to X. Join OB and produce. So angle, this is XO, R AOB is 60 degree. AOB is 60 degree. Or you can say that XOY is 60 degree. It is your construction of third type. Now the exercise is given in this. In this exercise, question number 1 is given. Construct an angle 90 degree. And initial point of a given ray, justify your construction. First of all, you take a ray BC. At B, you want to draw. To construct angle ABC at B. Where you want to draw? At B, you want to construct the angle. So, very simply, you will get. What will you do here? You will get the line BC. At B, 90 degree you draw. At B, you take a compass, 90 degree, I have told you in the previous page, mark an arc, same radius, second arc, then same radius, third arc, 120, then bisector of it, like this. Here you will mark, and from this point also you mark, you will join it, it is your, what is ray AB, and you want to bisect it. Justify your answer. How will you draw the bisector? Put the compass here. More than half of it, mark an arc here, one arc here, and from this point 90 degree, you see that 90 degree, you are marking the another one. One is here, and one from this point. Both are intersecting at a point. Join this and produce. Join this and produce. You are getting this. It is a bisector. If it is a D, so BD is bisector of angle ABC. BD is the bisector of angle ABC. How? Because from midpoint you are, from these 2 points more than half you are, when you measure it, you will get, measure the angle ABD by the protector. Angle CBD is equal to 90 degree, 45, 90 by 2, that is 45 degree. What will you get? You will get it is 90 by 2, these two are 45 degree each. So justification, you measure it and write down. Second question is given, construct an angle of 45 degree at an initial point of a given ray and justify your answer. Construct angle of 45 degree want. In this you have already 90 degree and constructed bisector. Initial point of given ray and justify your construction. If you want to bisect it, I have bisected it. draw the bisector, it is a 45. Same thing in the second case. First you measure it by the protractor, you get it is a 90 degree. Or this side you also get same point. So it is the 90 degree is your answer, but here a bisector I have drawn, it is the second question. Second question is given, and initial point at the ray, and then justify your answer, 45. How will you do? 45 degree will be the half of 90. First of all, AOB 90 degree. So OB is bisector of angle AOB. So AOB is equal to this 45 degree. This is given here also as well as here also. So what will you get? Draw a line, ray. At O, you draw a arc. First of all, 90 degree you will draw. By compass, I am drawing the 90 degree by 5 arcs. 1, 2, 3, 4, and from here 5. After 90, dotted line I have drawn. Dotted line means it is not the, it is a helpful line which will give you the 45. So now the more than half, from here 90 degree you put, more than half you take and you mark an arc. From the this you also mark an arc, so you get the bisector. OB is the bisector of this and gets the 45 degree, half of the 90. Third question is given, question number 3. Question number 3 is given, construct the angles of the following. 30 degree, 22 and a half and 15. 30 is half of 60. 22 and a half is half of 45. And 15 is half of 30. So accordingly you will draw. How will you get? First of all you will draw a 30 degrees. How? Half of 60. Draw a line. At B you take, first of all you draw a 60 degree. What will you draw? First of all you will draw a 60 degree by one arc, same radius, and then bisect it. Bisect means same radius also you can draw inside here, and from 60 you are getting here, it is a 30 degree. First one is over. Second one is 22 and a half, it is equal to 45 by 2, means 90 degree you will draw. First of all you draw a ray. After drawing a ray, I am drawing a 45 degree by 90 degree. It is a dotted line. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Five arc you will draw a 90. After 90, you will draw a bisector of this, means more than half of it. More than or full or not less than half. Greater value is not needed. Here, one arc, and from this point, you keep in your mind 90 degree. It is a 45 degree. Now dotted line again you will draw by scale. After drawing dotted line, where it intersect, it is a 45, or again the bisector of 45. Again you put the compass at this place and mark an arc inside here, and from this side also you mark the arc, and you are getting both are intersecting at a point. Join it and produce this line. When you are joining and producing, this line is your half of 45, which gives you 22 and a half, and the 15 degree. Next one is given the 15 degree. What is 15 degree? 15 degree is very simple. How will you draw? First of all, 30 degree. By the compass, you draw the line. Put a compass, 60 degree, it is a 60 degree line. 30 degree, you can't draw by protractor, without half of it. So 60 degree, half of 60 is 30, this line, then half of the 30. Half of the 30 means from here. You see very carefully. From here, and you will take the arc like this. More than half I have taken. More than half means more than full also, because there is a very close. So you can increase. So here, and from this place also you draw it. Both are intersecting at a point, join and produce, it is your 15 degree. Question number 4 and 5, two questions left, 4 questions is given. Question number 4, construct the following angle and verify the measure by protractor, 75, 105, 135. This is not possible by direct, without the half and bisecting. So 75 is a 45 plus, here 60 plus 15. 45 is 60 plus 15, you see that, 75. 60 plus 15 is 75 degree. So first of all you draw a 90 degree. It means this 15 you want beyond 60, it is a 60 degree line. So what will you do? First of all, you draw a line, then you draw a 90 degree. 90 degree is the dotted line. 90 means 60 plus 30. Do you know? 90 means 60 plus 30. So you can write 60 plus 30 by 2. Gives you 60 plus 15. That will be a 75. It means after the 60 degree, you more 15 degree want, which is half of the 60 and 90. So you put the compass at 90. And you will put the compass at, well, you are seeing 190 and 160, bisector of the angle between 60 and 90. You are getting a 15 degree. So that's give you angle, this is 75 degree. Another is given 105 degree. 105 means 60 plus 15. 60 plus 15 is 75, 90 plus 15 in 105. So 90 and 120 you bisect. Put the compass here. And 90 till 90, there is no problem. Draw a line perpendicular. So between 90 you will bisect it one more than. It is not necessary that only these two part you take. You take the radius beyond this also. This. And from here you mark this. Between 90 and 60 you get a, again half of this, that is 15 degree. So 90 plus 15 gives you 105 degree. You bisect between 90 and 120. So you are getting 105 degree. It is your angle which you are getting 105 degree from this place to this place. It is your angle from this place. 135 is 90 plus 45. What is given? 90 plus 45 is 135. So first you draw a line and then produce this side also. Because 120, 90 is here and other 90 is here. 90 plus 90, 180. So first of all you draw OA and you produce by dotted line and then by compass you draw a semicircle. What will you draw? By compass you draw which intersect both the sides. And then one side you put draw a 90 degree by this 5 arcs. I hope you know. This 90, not this side. This side you want one more 90 is left. And this 90, you will bisect this 90 degree by your compass more than half and then bisector. So you are getting this 45 degree. This angle is 40, this angle is 90. So 90 plus 45, this whole angle is your 135, 90 plus 30. One more is there, 60 plus 120 plus 15 also. So in that case, this 30 you bisect. First 30 and then, so 30 plus 160, 120 degree, 120 plus 30, 15 degree. So first you bisect this 60 and then again bisect. This is the long process. So only very simple way, 190 left side, one right side, 190 side you bisect. Last question is given, draw equilateral triangle if the sides are given. Equilateral triangle has given and its sides and justify your answer very simply. So first of all you draw any line BC I have drawn and BC is a, other all will be equal. So you take the radius of this and mark the arcs, same rate. Both the side you draw 60 degree because in equilateral triangle each angle is 60 degree. In equilateral triangle each angle is 60 degree. So both the end you will draw a 60 degree. One this side and one this side. Where they intersect it is the vertex and ABC is your equilateral triangle in which all the sides are equal. It is on the basis of angle. You can draw without angle also. BC is one side. Take BC, draw a BC by scale and then the radius you take up the BC and mark an arc here and same radius from B you arc this side. Both are intersecting at A, BC is your required triangle which is equilateral. By side drawing you can also draw or by angle also. Two types you can draw the equilateral triangle. Measure When you draw by angle, you measure the side by length and these will be equal. When you draw by sides, you measure the angles, all will be 60 degree. It is the verification. Thanks for this. And next chapter, lecture, I will explain the some other properties of the triangle, which is very important. It is very simple. After this, your 9th standard. Thanks.